Ayyan Kolam tank. The tank is situated about 1 kilometer from Arunachaleswara temple. On September 1, 1896, when Bhagavan Ramana arrived in Tiruvannamalai as a boy of 16 years, he first went to the sannidhi of Arunachaleswara in the temple to announce his arrival to the Lord's abode. Thereafter, he headed to Ayyan Kolam, where he got his head shaved, took a dip in the tank and discarded his clothes and the sacred thread. He donned a simple loincloth torn from his dhoti and re-emerged in a new avatar, which later resounded in the world as Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharshi. The Ayyan Kolam tank is mainly used for the Teppotsavam festival after the 10th day of Deepam, where the Lord sports with his consort in a flower-decked boat at night. There is also a small temple of Arunagiri Nada opposite the tank. After more than a century of Bhagavan's arrival to Tiruvannamalai, the tank today is surrounded by congested development and is in a state of poor maintenance. This video was taken around 2010, when the situation appears to have been better. Gurumurtam. Gurumurtam temple is the samadhi of Daiva Sikamani Desikar, who lived between 1291 to 1348 in Tiruvannamalai. The Samadhi of Daiva Sikamani was built in Keelnathur, a suburb of Tiruvannamalai. The temple that came to be known as Gurumurtam was built over this Samadhi. About 6 months after his arrival in Tiruvannamalai, Ramana was living under the Ilupai tree in Arunachaleswara temple. During this time, he was known as Brahmana Swami. Uddandi Nayanar visited Arunachala in December 1896 and during Arunachala Girivalam noticed the young Swami in deep tapas, lost to the world. Nayanar had studied numerous Tamil philosophic texts but could experience neither peace nor the self. Nayanar was deeply impressed and thought, "This is tapas, this is abidance. If such a one does not experience the self, who else will? By serving him, I may also experience the self." He firmly believed in this. Nayanar decided to stay under another nearby tree in the chill weather and devote himself to the service of the young tapasvi. Nayanar was thus the first attendant of Swami Ramana. One Annamalai Tambiran spent his time singing Devarams. Tambiran happened to see the Swami in tapas under the Ilupai tree. He was astonished and made it a point to have his darshans as frequently as possible. He thought that it would be good to take the Swami to Gurumurtam. It would benefit him personally and be better for the Swami too. So he broached the matter with Nayanar. Both of them pleaded with the Swami, saying, "Gurumurtam will be convenient for Swami. There will be no nuisance from the crowds. Yet it is close to Arunachala. Swami must consent to come there." The Swami consented. In February 1897, he moved to Gurumurtam and then became known as the Swami of Gurumurtam. The tapas continued uninterrupted at Gurumurtam. The austerity became more severe. Indifference towards physical comfort increased. The Swami never bathed or cleaned himself. His hair became matted. His nails grew long and curved. His hands fell into disuse. Gurumurtam was full of ants, but the Swami cared nothing about it. He was in their midst, unmindful of them. He was immersed in the self. To protect the Swami from ants, someone provided a stool with the legs immersed in water. But since the Swami leaned against a wall, the ants continued to infest the body. The wall which touched the Swami's back got darkened. This patch could be seen for a very long time, even after the Swami left Gurumurtam. Ramana stayed at Gurumurtam for a year and a half. This is what Bhagavan said of his stay in Gurumurtam. Days and nights would pass without my being aware of their passing. When anyone thought that I should have food, I would stretch a hand and something would drop in my hand. My hands were not useful for any other purpose. I would eat and rub my hand on my head or body and drop again into my continuous mood. This was my condition for some years from the time of my arrival. English translation of the Tamil text on the Kadapa stones. Grace of the Guru. A historical note on Tirukailaya Parampara Daiva Sikamani Desikar Swami. The acts of grace he performed in Tiruvannamalai are inscribed in the Arunachaleswara temple in the wall of the third prakara on the south, opposite to the Sthala Vriksha. He started this mutt in Tiruvannamalai in the early part of the 14th century. The present temple was constructed when he attained Jiva Samadhi. Till this day, he is in Siva Yoga and continues to radiate his grace. This lineage is currently functioning in Kundrakudi, going by the name of Tiruvannamalai Adhinam as the 45th generation. Gracious Kumaraswami Munivar has written a verse in praise of him as follows. Well versed in the 28 Agamas and the 4 Vedas, removing without fail the darkness, attachment and ignorance of devotees and conferring the true Jnana, is the great Arunachala Deva called Sikamani Sadguru. This inscription was raised during the Kumbhabhishekam on 2nd September 1990. Daiva Sikamani Desikar was born in the latter half of the 13th century in the Adi Saiva tradition. He was blessed with a divine darshan even at an young age. He was instructed in the true jnana by his guru, the great Saiva saint Arulnadi Sivacharyar. He requested his guru that God should manifest as a Swayambhu Linga for him to carry out his devotional practices. The guru directed him to worship at the temple at Sri Kalahasti. At Sri Kalahasti, the Lord manifested as a Swayambhu Linga outside the main temple just for him. He then took that linga and worshipped it in Tiruvannamalai as his Atmik Linga. The worship of this deity continued for several successive generations, and when the Mutt was formed in Tiruvannamalai, it radiated grace as their main deity between the 17th and 30th order. From the time of relocation of the Mutt from Tiruvannamalai to Kundrakudi, the Linga is radiating grace at the Kundrakudi Mutt. Desikar has performed many miracles. One of his miracles is the reviving of the dead horse of the King Veeravallala, who reigned from 1291 to 1348 AD. Pacchaiamman Temple. In 1996, the Sri Pacchaiamman Mannar Swami Trust was formed, comprising six hereditary Agamudiyar families of Tiruvannamalai, whose ancestors have been traditionally serving Goddess Pacchaiamman at a location at the southeast slope of Arunachala for many generations. The site of the current temple is believed to have originated sometime during the Chola period, 8th to 11th centuries. But the temple, as we know it today, is only about 120 years old. In the Pacchaiamman compound, there are 14 statues of Pacchaiamman's warrior guardians set out in two lines, with two representations of each warrior. There are also statues of Lord Munishwara's vahanas, vehicles. When asked how the goddess got the name Pacchaiamman, Sri Ramana said, "Pacchai means emerald color. When Parvati came to Gautama Ashrama to perform austerities to appease Ishvara, her form was of emerald color and she performed austerities at that place. Then it is said that she went around the hill, stayed at several places at different times, continuing her austerities, and finally merged into Shiva as half of his body, and came to be known as Apita Kuchamba." In 1905, when there was a plague crisis in Tiruvannamalai, Ramana Maharshi moved to Pacchaiamman Kovil for 6 months during the worst of the epidemic and returned to the caves on the south side of Arunachala when the plague crisis was over. Again, between January and March 1908, Ramana Maharshi returned to Pacchaiamman Kovil and lived there with Ganapati Muni and others for that period. It is recorded that Sri Ramana would visit this temple for oil baths. On one such occasion around 1915 or 16, the Maharshi Palaniswami Vasudeva Sastri and others left Virupaksha cave and proceeded to Pacchaiamman Kovil, taking oil and soap nut powder for an oil bath, as facilities for such a bath were ample at that place. It was on the way back from such a trip that Ramana had his second death experience at Turtle Rock. Isanya Mutt. Isanya Desikar, 1750 to 1829, whose mutt is located just outside Tiruvannamalai on the old Pradakshina road, was a distinguished yogi. He was born in 1750 in a small village called Rayavelur, which is located near the river Palar in northern Tamil Nadu. The child was given the name of Kandappan. Kandappan left home around the age of 16 to visit places of pilgrimage in the Tamil land and also in search of a guru to become a sannyasin. After spending long years in Chidambaram, Tiruvarur, etc., he finally came to Tiruvannamalai around his 60th year. Here he started staying near the present-day Isanya Mutt, which in those days was a forested area. He is said to have become an avadhuta in Tiruvannamalai and was constantly guarded by a couple of tigers while he was immersed in meditation. Many miracles and acts of grace are attributed to Isanya Desika Swami. He had predicted his time and date of death at the age of 79 in writing. He had composed a garland of hymns to Arunachala on various spiritual themes consisting of 100 verses. Bhagavan's visit to Isanya Mutt. It happened in the early days, sometime before 1920, when Bhagavan was in Skandashram. While on a pradakshina of the holy hill, Bhagavan rested a while at Isanya Mutt. The Mathadipati was all smiles as he welcomed the young and beloved Maharshi and informed him that he had been in the midst of a lecture to the young sadhaks and that it would be a great honour if Maharshi took up the instructions from there on. Bhagavan was left with little choice. He entered the lecture hall and accepted the high seat proffered by the Mathadipati himself. Finding that the lecture was on Gita Sara Lullaby, Bhagavan went ahead with it. We can only wonder at the great fortune of those young sadhaks, the splendor of the guru who refused to consider himself as any special incarnation, and the grandeur of his Upadesa that day. The Upadesa that he nevertheless gave in an earlier incarnation. After the completion of the video, somebody requested that I make a video on Gautama Ashrama and Bhagavan's bridge on the Pradakshina road. The two places derive some significance from being associated with Bhagavan Ramana. Gautama Ashrama is a small temple just before Suryalingam devoted to the sage Gautama. It is mentioned in Arunachala Puranam that Mother Parvati had come to Tiruvannamalai to complete her penance as the last stop before merging with Lord Shiva. Gautama Ashrama is mentioned as one of the main places where she had stayed for some time. Those days, the place was part of Arunachala and the forest surrounding it, where the sage had his ashram. The current small temple dedicated to the sage derives some importance from the fact that Bhagavan Ramana, during his earlier days at his ashram, would do full day Giri Pradakshinas with a retinue of followers following him and carrying lunch baskets. A mango grove adjoining Gautama Ashrama used to be a stopover in the mid-afternoon sun for having their lunch and resting for a while. Similarly, Bhagavan's bridge after Vayulingam was a culvert built across the mud road for rainwater drainage with about 3 feet walls on both sides of the road. It is reported that Bhagavan would sit on the left side wall sometimes for a break facing Arunachala. But during the past decade, with the laying of a tar road and a paved sidewalk, the culvert walls have almost disappeared.